Hello everyone, welcome back to the next part of Final Fantasy playthrough. So we're going to continue on to the boss fight. This is going to be my fourth attempt at killing this boss. So if you see this video, that means I probably killed him. If you don't see this video, then yeah, the opposite happened. I've been avoiding using Rydia's calls out of the sort of fear of him messing my whole group up, but honestly, like, because he does like the counterattack, but honestly, I might just have to use him. I need that big 5,000-6,000 damage output, or else I'll just never kill him with the minimal output of like 3,000, 4,000, 2,000, whatever. Also, let me do something real quick as well, equip or item. Oh, I forgot about this. Let's take these and bring them up here. Up quite a way to go down here. Quite a journey to get to the actual boss fight. And then once you get there, I think all my shit should be refilled anyway, so I might as well do a couple of these attacks. Maybe to level somebody up, but once you spend like 10 minutes just, even if you avoid all the fights, if you spend like 10 minutes running down to the battle, then you sit there, or not 10 minutes, but like you spend an amount of time to get down there, then you have to sit there through the whole battle, or that they do like the whole cutscene and dialogue and all that stuff, and then like 10 minutes later you finally get a chance to hopefully not die to him. Like, I feel like if you're gonna make a cutscene slash dialogue that's that long, and obviously like back then you couldn't skip that stuff, you might as well at least put the save room like right outside the freaking thing. Can you just run? Holy shit, dude. That's the other thing, like even trying to get to the boss fight, like I have to keep dealing with this bullshit of running from these fights that are just, you can never find one when you actually want to fight, and when you're not trying to fight and you're trying to get somewhere, you can't seem to get away from it. Definitely becomes more, like the first couple times around it's not bad, but when you die a few times and you have to keep doing this whole run over and over and over again, at some point it does become very monotonous and frankly a waste of time. That's what you want, but when it comes down to it, running to a boss fight for 10 minutes and watching dialogue, there's nothing fun of it. You're not really learning anything from it, so it's literally just a waste of time. You get like 3 boss attempts within like a hour span of time. Changing up the strategy a little bit here. See how it goes. Feel a little too soon because you didn't go yet. Came the Big Bang. Surprised the Big Bang didn't do as much damage that time, but white. To have to, if he does a big bang before she heals, that'd be bad, but if she heals first, then not as big of a deal. The virus one is a bit more annoying because it damages everybody, but... hit a lot harder. I think it's maybe because Kane was in there, I don't know. I definitely hit a lot harder. Card, bro. It's gonna be the last battle that I'm gonna do before the game ends. I'll throw whatever the fuck out of him. Don't even care at this point. Gonna help me win? So be it. Let me see items. Okay, so he's about to use that thingy. Let's heal everybody. I don't know how much damage he'll do. Hopefully not a lot. Hopefully I'll continue doing like that small damage that it's been doing. Rosa heals everybody before this hits. Oh, thank God. This, yeah. Great if I just kill them. I'd love to see that screen. I'd very much love to see the screen of him dying. Oof. No way he used Mateo after all that. Did I kill him? No way. Fourth attempt. Once I finally decided to just use Ridia's calls, and they weren't actually. I thought like his counterattacks would do a lot more damage than they did. Maybe that's why I was so worried about it. But who knows if I would have gotten it earlier, but. Better now than another 50 attempts later, you know? I will not perish as long as there is evil in the hearts of people. Oh. cool animation. I did like Gold, or not Gold, but as a final boss. I did like his real form. It was pretty cool. Want to be born from a dragon hoisting the light and the dark. Arise high up in the sky. The still land. Failing the moon, the light eternity brings. Another promise. Oh snap. But he's got a crush. Oh shit, Kang is now a king as well. Well, I think that concludes the game, right? Yeah. Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you for sticking around through all the parts for different tips and advice. Glad I finally got this dude killed and finished out. Fourth attempt isn't terrible, but I think it's more so just the fact that it took so long to get to the boss every single time that I wanted to fight him. So even though it's only four attempts, it felt like it was so much time taken up. But anyways, overall, I enjoyed the game. I thought it was pretty good. Like I said, my second OG Final Fantasy game. New experience in a sense, because Mystic Quest is so minimal and everything is kind of fairly straightforward. In this, there's a lot more going on, more dungeons, things like that. So a little bit more strategy and whatnot. So a bit of a different experience for me, especially from other games that I normally play. So, but anyways, hopefully I'll see you guys in whatever next playthrough that I do, whether it's something a little newer or another OG game like this or something for SNES, we'll see. But yeah, thank you again for watching, and I'll catch y'all later.